we getting money. Please do not act like you know me, cause we got the bag on. Tell them we getting money. Bitches gon' act like they love us, gon' treat for the bag on. Tell them we getting money.
Yo, what up, Cash Fam? My name is Matthew Craig, and today we are super lucky to have a guest that I know is just gonna, you guys are gonna go crazy for. So be sure to like, subscribe, comment, and get your thoughts down below. Yo, what can I say? He's been credited by the likes of Pitchfork and Complex as one of the pioneers of the New York drill wave that is just sweeping the entire planet. Since the release of his breakout freestyle, No Suburban, in 2017, he's drawn comparisons with some of the Big Apple rap goats, including 50 Cent and Biggie Smalls, and he's become a cultural phenomenon overnight. He's got over 120 million YouTube views, two projects under his belt, 2020's One and Only, and 2019's The Unlucky Kid, which, yo, I gotta let it be known, took up 8 of the top 10 spots on my Spotify rap this year. So, yo, I'm hyped for this one today. But he ain't just a rapper. He's an entrepreneur. He recently linked up with his bro Sleepy Hollow and RCA Records to create the Winner's Circle imprint, a label on which his debut album, Proud of Me Now, is set to be released in the next coming week. He's coming out of Flatbush, a place that he describes as the capital of Brooklyn. You fell in love with his deep voice, the one and only Chef G. You're welcome to AUD, Australia's Hip Hop Connect, my brother.
Oh, man, that's an intro, man. We in the building, man.
That's how we do it.
Appreciate being here.
How you doing, my man? It's good to talk to you today. How you feeling?
Feeling good, man. Everything good. Gucci.
That's it. Stay blessed. Stay blessed. Bro, I got to be straight up. Yo, I'm hyped to talk to you, man, because as I said, I've been following you for a minute, and I feel like you're one of these legit stories of a dude just like with raw talent on the street, with his bros, uploads a video, goes on the internet, takes off, goes freaking viral, and lol, that's 3 years ago, and now look at where you are now, man. Congrats. You just signed a major label imprint. How does that feel, bro? It's been like 3 years rapid, man. How's that journey been for you?
That shit, it was like, I would explain it as, it was a hard path. It wasn't easy, but it wasn't hard. You know what I'm saying? Like, it wasn't easy, but it wasn't hard. You know what I mean?
Yeah, bro.
But it was a mission. And yeah, we got it done, though.
For real. And what have you learned along the way, man? Like, what have you got any advice for any other cats with that quick come up who are maybe hustling and she starts to take off? Like, what have you learned on your journey?
Shit. First thing you need to know as an artist, new artist coming up and shit, is you're going to get famous before you get rich. You understand? So you got to know how to move, you understand? And and sometimes staying in your old environment ain't too good. You know what I mean? You got to get up and get up out of there, you know what I mean?
And what's that look like for you, man? What's that transformation look like for you?
You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't live in Brooklyn no more, you know what I'm saying? I moved out. I can't stay out there, you know what I'm saying? Like, you don't want to put yourself in a predicament you don't want to be, you know what I mean?
100%. 100%, man. We've seen drill, like, and particularly New York drill now, man. Like, it's sort of, it's taken over the world, bro. Out here in Australia, we've got acts like 1-4 that are popping off. It's all the rage at the moment, man. But it hasn't always been that way. Yeah, like, you were one of the first to blend sort of what was going on in Chicago with, you know, Keith and Dirk and that with what was happening in London. Like, how intentional was that for you, bro? And did you see it, like, advancing like this in a few years' time?
You know, it's crazy. I used to say it. Like, I used to tell everybody, like, yo, everything is going to be as one just now. Like, I've seen it from before, you know what I mean? That's why I used to use the beats that I use, and I put my songs and my videos where I put it, you know what I'm saying? Because I wanted to grab the fans from early so they could see, like, I'm, like, original, you know what I mean? And now everybody on it now, but I've been on it, you know what I mean? Been seeing it.
How does that feel, man, to be sort of credited as a pioneer, like, the leading genre in the world right now, bro?
That shit feel amazing, man. That's lit. For a fact.
You're only early 20s as well and still got the debut album, man. Like, you grew up in, like, a crowded house, you know, on the block in Flatbush, surrounded by, you know, Caribbean family, Haitian and Trinidadian, if I'm correct, man. How – you can hear that sort of blend in your music, man, with the melodies. You can hear stuff from, like, hood narratives to, like, Creole sort of influences. How much has your culture impacted your music, bro?
I think it impacted, like, fully. So I grew up with my whole family in a one bedroom, you know, cousins, sisters, all that, and music, everything is one, you know what I'm saying? So I would hear soca music, I would hear Biggie and them from my cousins that was older than me. I would hear every type of music, and I guess it just stuck with me. But I didn't know I would have been a rapper. That was never my plan.
For real.
Understand? So I guess it was just already in me. know what I mean?
Was music a bit of an escape for you from your situation? Or?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, music was something I did and something I listened to just so I could put myself in like a different area at the time, you know what I mean? Like, just put myself somewhere else, act like on something else, you know what I mean?
Yeah, for real. For real. Yo, a lot of artists, like, congrats on the recent signing deal as well, man. But a lot of artists, when they sign a deal, yo, they get a bit of an endorsement and a license to sort of experiment sonically, you know what I mean? And you hear that on a Dubois album. But you've always done that, to be honest, from, like, We Get Money turning up to, like, something spacey like Designer. You've always been experimental, man, and switching up
facts. The sound.
Is that something we can expect on the new record, man? What can we expect or surprise us sonically, you know what I mean?
Definitely, like, what you could expect on a new album is about, like, different type of music, like, for different type of emotions. Because every day you wake up with different feelings. You don't feel the same every day, you know what I mean? Yeah. So you need music for those type of moments, you know what I mean? So that's what it's for. The music is for the moments that you really need it for, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for real.
That's what it's for. That's what you're going to hear on this album.
Hype. And what are you sort of listening to? Or what's the stuff that you listen to that influences you, man? Like,
shit, I listen to everything. I listen to every type of music. You hear me? Soft shit, drill shit, everything. You feel me? I'll put it as one.
Yeah, bro. What does the future look like, man? The sky's the limit for Chef G. What does it look like? In like, it's been a 3-year come up. What's the next 5? What's the next 10? Where's the top, bro?
You just gotta keep going. I never put myself at a level. I just want to keep leveling up.
Yeah,
so that's what I always say. Like, just keep going.
I like it, bro. We haven't got long this morning. So what I want to do, bro, is I want to jump into a bit of like a rapid fire quick questions with you. Yeah, I'm gonna shoot some quick questions at you.
Yeah, go ahead.
You just hit me with the answers that come straight to your head. Yeah, we'll just have a bit of fun with it.
All right, bro.
All right. Let's go. If you could have one superpower, what would it be?
Run fast.
The flash type shit. I like it.
Flash.
Cats or dogs, bro?
Dogs.
Dogs. All right. What is your most used emoji?
The the wet sun.
What is your favorite way to smoke weed?
On our own smoke.
Chef G don't smoke. You heard it here first. Who was your first celebrity crush?
Who was the first? I don't know. Probably was Nicki.
Bet. A New York thing. Fair. Favorite song of your own?
My favorite song of mine?
Yeah.
Lights On.
Fair. What did you have for breakfast this morning?
Cereal, cinnamon toast crunch.
Oh, nice. If you made it to the Olympics, what sport is Chef G competing in at the Olympics?
I don't know, but it'll be something with like fighting or lifting weights or something.
MMA shit or something. tight. What's your favorite thing to do that's not music related, bro?
Play Call of Duty.
He's a gamer. Tight. Where's the best fried chicken? Where are you going to get the best fried chicken?
In Brooklyn. Chinese store in the floss. The Chinese store in the floss.
What's on your phone background?
Oh, picture of my cousin Caesar. He locked up. Free him.
I bet. Free Caesar. Dream holiday destination. If you could go anywhere in the world.
Colombia.
All right. Say less. If you could hang out with one cartoon character, who would it be?
Naruto.
Tight. What is the last TV show that you binge watched?
Martin.
Cool. If you had a time travel machine, would you go to the future or the past?
Neither.
All right, just stay in the present,
Chef. I was one to know.
All right, yeah. I like it. What's on your rider?
You said what?
What's on your rider for sure?
Oh, Cuban bracelet, prong set.
Yeah, the Cuban.
Good prospect.
Tight.
Okay, basically.
Dream collaboration. If you could collab with any artist in the world, dead or alive, who would it be?
Biggie.
Yeah. Yo, that would be some real New York shit, bro. I think the fans
definitely
would be for that, man. That'd be wild. And last one, last question for you. Pineapple on pizza, yes or no?
Hell no. Hell fucking no. I hate that shit.
My guy. Chef G, my brother, it's been a pleasure to talk to you, man. Congratulations on everything that's been happening. We're excited for the new album out here next week, and we hope to link up when all this corona stuff's open and you can come back to Australia, man, and we can link up proper, yeah?
Definitely, bro. I appreciate you having me, bro.
Always, my brother. It's much love. It's much love.
We getting money, man. We getting money, man. We getting money. We getting money, man. We getting money, man. We getting money. We getting money.